Good evening, Commonwealth, and thanks for watching the Channel 2 News. I'm Ashley McDowell. Let's take a look at tonight's top stories. Police aren't taking a break during the holiday as multiple people were arrested. Also tonight, a bill is sitting with the governor that will address property's ugly face. And a former president gives advice on the military presence in the CNMI. In sports, quick! Name the top five Saipan basketball players of all time. Stay with us. These stories and more are next.
Hey, boy, don't delete this message. I don't want you to forget. This is where we keep the family together, okay?
I got this, Nana.
Last Christmas, when Nana got sick, she showed us how she makes the holidays special. Because time will come when we have to do those ourselves. Now it's our turn, Nana. And I'm sure we'd always make you proud.
Watching the video, Grandma made Mom.
Oh, I miss her.
It's Christmas time. Everybody be happy.
Because everything beautiful about the holidays are the ones you've kept alive in our hearts.
At one of Saipan's beaches, this mother lays about 100 eggs under the cover of darkness. She hides her nest as best she can and then slowly makes her way back to the ocean. The eggs hatch and the babies head for the sea where they will face a daily dose of danger. Just 1 in 1,000 will make it to adulthood. Those that do will one day lay their own eggs. Sea turtles are protected under CNMI law. If you see one that is stranded or if you see illegal activity, call the hotline at 287-8537.
As 2019 fades away, we say it was nice knowing you. Now move over. Let 2020 take over. KSPN2 doesn't know what will happen, but we know whatever happens, we'll be there to report it fairly and responsibly. Now, as we start our 14th year of serving this community, we'd like to thank you for making it all happen. And as for 2020, I say, good luck.
Hafa Day, Tirawami, and good evening, Commonwealth. Today is Thursday, December 26th, 2019. The Department of Public Safety has arrested 4 individuals involved in a theft to an abandoned hotel in Azlito. According to a release from DPS, the 4 suspects were caught in the act, taking galvanized pipes from an abandoned hotel along Flame Tree Road. The caller stated a suspicious vehicle was heading toward the back of the abandoned hotel as he was passing by. When the caller drove up to the hotel, he heard loud banging coming from the lower floor and saw 2 pickup trucks parked at the bottom. Police arrived and intercepted Bo Fei Li, Goi Hoi Li, Kun Za Li, and Zoi Li Fa, which admitted to removing the galvanized pipes from a stored area within the hotel with intent to take them. The 4 suspects were arrested and transported to the Department of Corrections, where they were booked and detained. Special punishments are underway for those who are committing malicious mischief, Sally Lemus reports.
A bill, now sitting with the governor, is setting standards for punishments with vandalism. Representative Joseph Lipon Guerrero, who authored the bill, says his intent is to stop vandalism in the CNMI.
We've seen a lot of public facilities, and especially our bus stops for our kids. And I have to say that the doing is of the youth, the minors. So we're trying. The bill is trying to say send a message out that if you deface public property and even private property, you should be held accountable for.
Guerrero says a lot of bus stops, beach pavilions, and buildings on island are filled with graffiti using profanity words. Unoccupied buildings are also being broken into and wrecked.
We've seen then the windows broken off, doors kicked off. Those are the kind of thing that we want to make sure. We want to make sure that we don't have this on this island, in the CNMI, and hope that the community can learn from this.
Vandalism is defined as an intentional act that defaces, destroys, or damages another's property without that person's permission. This bill sets special sanctions for those caught doing vandalism.
The first offense is like $500 in fine for anyone being caught. And the severity of this is we want to make sure that parents, students who get caught vandalizing will be part of the process to if an example needs to be painted, then the parents should be responsible as well to be painting that what was defaced in the public property on buildings itself. So we want to make sure that parents are held accountable for that.
Guerrero, along with other lawmakers, believe the law on vandalism should be revisited and made stiffer. This is Sally Limis for KSPN News.
Thank you, Sally. The CNMI was mentioned and talked about by former President Barack Obama, thanks to Representative Sheila Babauta.
Half a day, President Obama. My name is Sheila Jack Babauta. I'm from the Mariana Islands. Mm-hmm. My question for you is regarding the military presence in the Pacific Islands.
Did you ever, once in your life, think that you were going to speak to President Barack Obama?
No, oh my goodness. I think one of my favorite moments of him was when, of course, you've seen all his speeches, right? He was with Oprah, he has sat down on many different stages, like having all these different interviews. And so I was really shocked. Like, I was born and raised on Saipan. Like, never in a million years did I think I was going to be looking at President Barack Obama, one of my favorite presidents.
Attending a leadership development and community engagement program under the Obama Foundation Leaders Asia Pacific, Representative Sheila Babauta was one of the chosen to raise a question to former President Barack Obama. She chose to ask about the planned relocation of U.S. Marines from Okinawa, Japan to Guam, and said military buildup on Guam will also affect the CNMI.
You have to know what it is that you want and what's realistic. And you also have to make sure that your own group, you've worked out your differences in terms of what you want. Because my suspicion would be that even among islanders, there are some different views. Some people would say, oh, come on, because we think there's going to be more business, or there's going to be more economic development, or what have you. And there are others who say, we don't want this. And if you have those divisions and your agenda is unclear, then it will be harder for you to be able, in a unified voice, to project and tell a story that gives you some allies and gives you leverage.
So his answer was spot on. I really appreciated his answer and his advice to us. And you know what I took away from that was resolve internal conflict, right? Number one, what do you want as a Commonwealth? What do you want to negotiate? What is on the table when it comes to military presence in the Marianas, right? What are we willing to give up? What are we willing to offer?
Not many are aware of military presence in the Pacific. And with this question, it has planted a seed, raising awareness around the world.
And I think that this is a conversation that we all need to have, we all need to be aware of, because it heavily impacts our environment. We need to remember, along with how has the military really helped our people, right? It has helped our people become educated, travel the world, you know, get out of poverty. The military has helped us a lot. And I mean, most recently we can remember their involvement during Super Typhoon Yutu, right? They were here, they were helping us recover and rebuild, and we're very grateful. But at the same time, we really need to remember where we stand in all of this and how it's going to affect us. So that's where we try and look for the middle ground.
Here on Capitol Hill at the CNMI Legislature, I'm Sally Limes reporting for KSPN News.
And as many of you know, it is the holiday season, and with that is sobriety checkpoints to ensure the safety of you and those around you on the road.
The Department of Public Safety will be conducting two more sobriety checkpoints before the year is over. Tomorrow, Friday, December 27th, the first checkpoint will be from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. along Chalampali, Arnold Chalinlaulau to Garapan. And the second checkpoint will be along Beach Road, San Jose to San Antonio from 10:30 p.m. to 12 a.m. And on Monday, December 30th, from 7:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m., the first checkpoint will be along Beach Road, Garapan to Susupi. The second checkpoint will be along Chalampali Arnold, Garapan to Chalinlaulau from 10 p.m. to midnight. A release from DPS states the checkpoints is to defer driving after drinking. This increases the awareness of the dangers of driving drunk, drowsy, drugged, or distracted. The checkpoints were predetermined based on the amount of auto accidents related to alcohol in these areas.
Coming up, a festival is happening this weekend to wrap up the Christmas in the Marianas. You won't want to miss this. Find out more after the break.
Mom, are you sure? What about the shutters? And do you have your medicine?
Don't worry about us, love, okay? You take good care of yourself. I'm in love. Yeah, sorry. The power went out, so I had to light up all the candles. Yes, baby, yeah. I'm just glad our home phone's working and we're able to contact you.
Do you have a team or company? Bring them to the Adventure Specialist, Saipan's homegrown Marianas Trekking. Our guided adventures will challenge and excite you, and our award-winning photographers will capture it in a unique and unforgettable way. Check out our off-roading, go-karting, mountain biking, hiking, and snorkeling. And we have top-notch rental gear, too. So bring your team, bring your family, or bring your best friend. Marianas Trekking inside the Mariana Resort.
Wish a very blessed holiday season to all the people of the Marianas.
To wish each and every one of you in our CNMI and across our region a very, very Merry Christmas.
We want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Welcome back to the Channel 2 News. Christmas isn't over in the Marianas yet, as a festival to wrap up the celebration is occurring this weekend. It's called the Mochizuki Festival, an annual celebration in Japan that prepares for the new year, and it's going on right here in Saipan. The celebration is the pounding of the mochi, meaning glutinous rice. The festival kicks off at 5:30 p.m. and will include Japanese dance, American Sign Language, the Hopwood Middle School Glee Club, Marianas High School Rhythm and Harmony, dance groups, and more. Monchi pounding. Christmas in the Marianas is organized by the Marianas Visitors Authority. The CODA shuttle service will be provided from American Memorial Park parking lot to the Paseo de Mariana's starting at 5 p.m. For more information, contact the Mariana's Visitors Authority. On Guam, it's hundreds of thousands of dollars waiting to be used by the Guam Regional Transit Authority to purchase transit vehicles. KUAM reports.
Hafidé, CNMI, here's what's making news on Guam. The Guam Regional Transit Authority is sitting on a rather unexpected surprise, almost $500,000 waiting to be used.
You can call it an early Christmas gift from Uncle Sam, one that's just been sitting around for GRTA to open for the past 14 years.
I was over at Hawaii November 22nd for a medical appointment, but it took time from my schedule. And I went and met the U.S. Department of Transportation to find out if there are any funding opportunities that we can take advantage of.
GRTA Executive Manager Selba Bauta says the feds told him hundreds of thousands of dollars have been sitting waiting for Guam to use.
And I was told that since 2005, GRTA had $400,000 to purchase paratransit vehicles. So that's money that we're going to use to purchase paratransit vehicles.
And with plans for GRTA to take over paratransit operations in the new year, news of free money couldn't have come at a better time.
I was ratified, yeah. So it's something that somehow the government hasn't been able to recognize that $400,000 has been available for quite a while.
And in business news, Jeju Air has given the gift of new arrivals to Guam. The airline launched a new daily direct service from Muan, a new gateway from South Korea, for the winter season. The service started yesterday and runs through March 7th. In October, the airport said it's great news for island residents, offering a new destination option to visit for the local tourism economy, now directly connected to new Muan Airport, serving almost 1.9 million residents in South Korea. The new air services increased the airport's revenue for fiscal year 2020. And for more, check out KUAM.com.
Thank you, Jason. Coming up, these masters fly around like a bunch of UFOs. We're going to identify real UFOs next in this KSPN2 Sports Exclusive.
Holidays happening at Docomo Pacific's Red Friday. Purchase select phones on our popular Now program and choose a free gift, like free wireless earphones or huge discounts on the latest smartwatch. Prepaid friends get free load with select prepaid phones. And get a chance to win a Nintendo Switch when you take a selfie with our new AI dog, Spark. Come in for a happening holiday now. Docomo Pacific, better together. Some conditions apply.
Watch The Visitors Channel online, on time, anytime, at SaipanTV.com. Where to go, what to see, what to do. Restaurants, spas, activities, and culture, it's all in one place, in high definition, on your mobile device. SaipanTV.com. Check it out.
You deserve more.
I know it's been hard. Come on, let's go for a ride.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now this feels like home.
Dial Rent-A-Own. Making lives better since 1987.
Buenas sports fans, Merry Christmas. Oh, what a great day it was to stay home and watch basketball. We got to see some of the best players in the world. You know, anyone who's played sports has their all-time personal favorites. Philippine professional basketball Jericho Cruz tells us his favorite moment playing basketball.
Winning championships, making all-star teams, game-winning buzzer beaters, all the stuff of great memories that the competition can bring out in a player. Jericho Cruz has been a star in the Philippines. He's got many highlights over the years. His favorite, last month in the Governor's Cup.
Actually, I got a lot. Yeah, I got a lot. But this recently, I played against like Magnolia. One of my teammates, he was shooting a free throw, and we were down by one. So right when he missed it, I got a putback. It was game over. We won.
Who are the five greatest basketball players in Northern Marianas history? Ask five people and you may get five different answers. Power forward and smooth shooting Tony Rigolofoy, who starred in the 70s and 80s, was the first basketball player to be inducted into the NMI Sports Hall of Fame. Peter Camacho, the master of the mid-range jumper, who once scored over 100 points in a game and was on the 94 microgame silver medalist, a strong candidate. High-flying shooting guard Ed Diaz played all out, 94 feet of hustle, offense and defense, a high-energy guy who probably won more league MVP trophies than any other player here. And no other player won more scoring titles than shooting guard Freddie Policeman, the lightning strike layup being his favorite lethal weapon. Tinian's Joel Untlan, a rugged forward, was a standout in high school in Oregon and would dominate on Saipan when given the opportunity. Didn't get much, though. Likewise, same with guard Fred Hokog from Rota High School. He was unstoppable every time he got on the court, but he didn't get much chance. In his only tournament on Guam, he averaged over 40 points a game, a tournament best. When Jericho played at MHS, he was one of the better players, sure. However, a few other players were just as good that time. What separates Jericho from everyone else is he went to the Philippines to play college basketball, where his game really took off. He was drafted 9th in the PBA draft. He's now a veteran. The NMI's all-time list is subjective. Everyone's entitled to their opinion, but no one else has accomplished more on a basketball court than Jericho Cruz.
A testament to his, hard work, and I think it's really hard to say, you know, because we've had some great players, and maybe if they had the opportunity, but for somebody from here to come out, it just shows that Jericho is probably one of the best ever, you know, if not the best. But again, we can't, that the 70s and 80s, you can't really, because they didn't have the opportunity. But again, props to Jericho.
Someone may put Tony Diaz on that list. You know, he will not give up. Nope, he won't give it up. He's driven to the basket so many times, I think he drinks gasoline because he never runs out of gas.
There's Tony Diaz, still hustling down court. Hey, this is the 40 and up league. The pass ahead to Tony, not as fast as he used to be, but he can stop as good as ever. And he lets Errol Pareto do his thing. Tito Alano, one of the best small engine repairmen on the island. He scores for PPG against Blue House. More Tito. He helps people fix things on and off the court. One does not necessarily need to jump to score in this league. Take Salazar, for example. PPG scored 76 points. Was it enough? Is it New Year's yet? Jonar, the drive, the dish. Errol, the deposit. Blue House runs away with this one, 99-76.
Here's the windup and the pitch.
I don't believe what I just saw.
Let's roll at Gold's Gym Saipan with group exercise for every body. Total Resistant Exercise, or TRX, helps develop your core and improve strength. And Zumba toning is probably the funnest way to get fit. Shake Cafe is a great place to stop by for meal replacement or supplements. Today is the first day of the rest of your life.
Traveling or laying over on Guam? Don't wait around. Zip into Guam Adventures at Zipline Park inside the Hilton Resort and Spa. Guides will take you through a series of zips, starting with a mountain course and then zip over the ocean with spectacular views of Tumon Bay. Six zip lines and all, deliver a thrilling experience, and it's family friendly, so bring the kids ages 6 and up. You'll love the security of double lines and a new braking system to make riding smoother. The towers are named after the islands in the Marianas. We call it the Island Hopper. Your guides will teach you what you need to know to soar through the jungle with a bird's eye view. Best of all, for residents of Saipan, Tinian, and Rota, you can book this experience at 20% savings. Log on to guamadventures.com and during checkout, use offer code HOFA20. Book it and zip it today. We'll even pick you up.
Today's high was 86, low 79, humidity 70%. Tomorrow, partly cloudy, isolated showers, east winds 10 to 20 miles an hour, high 87, low 77. Caesar, kind of choppy out there, 69 feet. Sunrise 6:41, high tide 9:27, low tide at 2:50. And the sunset tomorrow night, Friday night, 5:54. Ashley, see that partial solar eclipse?
I did.
Eclipse today?
Well, I saw it.
I know you were working. You were at your desk. We don't have any windows in here. Did you see it?
I stepped outside for a minute to try to check it out.
What'd you think?
But I made the mistake of looking at it with my eyes.
Oh, now you can't even see me now. Probably.
It was hurting. That was a big mistake for sure. Yeah, but I kind of saw it a little
the
bit.
The peak, by the way, of 4:56, and it was about 90% covered. So it was just like getting dark a little bit. It's like the sun going down, but not spectacular or anything.
No, nothing too big.
Not as good as the DPS Christmas Carol singers
and dancers. I think about to watch that right
this.
Now.
You haven't seen this because you've been flying all over the world here.
Traveling.
But here it is.
All right, let's check it out.
With our pleasure, we present to you DPS Carolers.
Here with Joel.